Basically, I'm trying to bring awareness of our pollinators, because like the bees, the bumblebees a while back, they were dying off. The monarchs are now starting to have problems. And so I wanted to bring a conversation about insects and pollinators, especially the monarchs. And I was like, what can I find in the world of 3D printing? This was all done on my 3D printer. And this is an example. The tail fell off again.
Is it supposed to glue? I don't know.
But it's an actuating butterfly. And basically you have a little button that you press, and the rubber band allows it to flap the wings. I'll pass it around so that way you can kind of play with it. It's really thin. This is a failure, and this is a failure. But, how do you learn if you don't go out and explore? So I said, let me explore. Can I find something that I want that kind of is in alignment with my desire to educate people about the importance of putting wildflower habitats in your front yard? Because that way we can keep the diversity of these insects going, especially during this time of year. And so when I found this model on Thinkiverse, I was just thrilled, because I'm like, I don't know how to design this. This guy designed it, and not only did he design it, but he gave me all the information regarding how do you protect the monarchs, how do you create an environment that's inviting, that they will come and feed and multiply. The other thing that I've been working on is 3D lithopane, and it looks like a white box, but the minute you put it up to the light, you'll see a picture, and you can pass this around. And because I have a passion for photography, I've been really exploring with different designs, and actually creating my own business card. So you can kind of see the different designs of
What program does this?
There's several programs, but one of them is at OpenSCAD and Thinkiverse. They have a customizer. So you use their customizer, or you can do a type 3D lithopane, and there are plenty of software out there online that you can take your photo, bring it up, and create the lithopane, then you send it to the 3D printer. So it's real simple. I mean, I'm just exploring. But now my next step is to take a butterfly, and this is the monarch. I'm going to try to do like the tiger butterfly and just kind of create this whole series of flying insects. But I learned, because now I know how this works, now I can learn how to design it. So that's one of the things that I want to encourage all of you, is that if you don't know something, you do somebody else's work to understand it. Once you understand it, now you can explore and change it out and mix it up and just kind of
create your own style. That started out with us using a customizer on Thinkiverse. If you go to Thinkiverse and look for lithopane.
Let's put it up to the light. I have a few pictures.
Thinkiverse.
I have a collection of German beer steins. And in the bottom of some of the old ones, they have lithopanes. For drinking, you look up there and they have the eyes look fresh.
Yeah, because they're normally done with like glass and ceramic. And this is pretty cool, doing it with 3D printing.
I saw something on Twitter that said that they found a group of monarch butterflies that overwintered in South Florida.
Nice! I did not know that. I know they fly down to Mexico. It's a long flight. They go all the way up to Canada, and they actually come through Texas. This is why, for me, it's really important to bring that awareness.
Yeah, but this was just another group.
That's nice.
It is quarter after.